You complete me. I would sacrifice anything for you. Often, we develop a subconscious benchmark of what true love is. We aspire to be all that someone needs, and we're prepared to sacrifice for our partner, and we expect the same in return. The problem with this is that nobody can really complete us. They cannot be the solution to our pain. People can only support us through our own journey of self-love, self-healing, and self-acceptance. Our partner cannot give us fulfillment, no matter how much they love us. When we need someone to give to us in a very specific manner in order to feel loved, it's because we have needs that have to be fulfilled. And these needs can create gaps that heavily influence our definition of what love is. When we examine it deeply, we might find that the source of our expectations of what love is doesn't actually come from what is right or what is fair or what is normal, but rather from our need for people to give to us in a way that makes us feel complete. If we have fears of abandonment, we'll be happy as long as our partner gives us a sense of security. If we have fears that we are not good enough, then we'll be happy if our partner constantly validates us. As long as our partner continuously fills up that gap within us, we'll feel like the relationship is perfect, like we're happy. But people are always changing, and they cannot fill our gaps forever. Either they change or our gaps get wider. This is why we can find ourselves wondering why we are now so unhappy when before we were so happy. To be happy in love, we have to first know the ways in which we can give happiness to ourselves instead of seeking happiness externally with each relationship. It is when we don't rely on someone else to complete us that our happiness isn't tied to other people, and we are truly free to be happy always.